damage. Somebody say being very jealous.
Amen. Being very
jealous. So he got up there to see a God that is a jealous God.
Yes.
Tear up stuff.
Yes.
And in the midst of that, he said, that's not me.
Jesus. Amen.
Oh!
Amen.
See, I'm trying to get there because we're getting in the kingdom. So you got to watch for and those that have power. When we get to that certain rim, we can't be like one that will kill.
All right.
You know, that, look at somebody, that's the assignment of the devil, to steal, kill, and to destroy. There are sometimes we got to confine, confound our power. Come on, somebody. And sometimes we might have to get away. Come on, somebody, and have a little talk with Jesus.
Yes, yes.
To keep from hurting anybody.
Amen.
Because I feel Jesus.
Bless your Lord.
Because having this, look at somebody said, the baddest prophet.
The baddest prophet.
Having a spirit of very jealous could have been a very dangerous person. From the children of Israel, and look at, he's not talking about it. I ain't hear him talking about Jezebel who got a hit out on him. But we know, you know the dealio. But he's talking about the children of Israel. Man, I'm upset with the children of Israel, and you know what? Being upset with the children of Israel. Now I don't know what I might do.
Mm-hmm.
And those that are in the power position like Elijah have to be very careful that they don't allow a spirit of very jealous to creep in.
Yes.
Because look at somebody said it is a killer.
It is a killer.
And so because we got to go, look at somebody said we got to go to the next level. He come back after all of that to find that ain't God. All of that destruction and it's not God.
Yes, yes, yes.
So he could have a koshala. He could have took on a spirit of destruction and destroyed everybody, but it would not have been God. And like I said, God is the only one that has the power to take vengeance.
Yes, yes, yes.
It doesn't matter what folks do. I mean, I know some of us, even the best, I know leaders. I'm talking to leaders right now. I know sometimes we wanna like use that power, and we wanna use that because of how people treat us. How they do the hard work and the labor that we do. But nevertheless.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If you don't want to get where I'm going to get next, look at somebody and say, you got to look over right now. You got to look over even the children of Israel, God's very beloved, chosen. And you got to stay with God. Look at somebody and say, stay with him. I'm talking to the leaders. Stay with him.
Stay with him.
Hallelujah, because you're a bad prophet. You are God's shitty old shabba.
Amen.
You cannot let the people bring you to a level, oh God, where you act out and then something be not of God.
Amen.
It don't be him. Y'all hear me?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So watch the word of the Lord, because I hope y'all catch this for the very first time. Because God is getting ready to set up order in his church. I'm coming, girl. He's getting ready to set up order, but he's going to make sure the next group that he calls into the kingdom.
Amen.
Tell somebody they cannot have of the spirit of very jealous.
Amen.
Hallelujah, because he's going to use them mightily. They're going to be bad. I mean bad, I'm using it because I want you to see it. It's not a bad thing to use it like that, because anybody that God drops a mantle on. Lord have mercy. Anybody that God drops a mantle on is a bad somebody. We got a lot of preachers out there, and we got a lot of teachers and apostles. Y'all gonna hear me. We got a lot of evangelists. Y'all gonna hear me. We got a lot of pastors, but everybody don't have a mantle that God drops on.
Yes, amen. Amen, amen.
You can read a